Today we'll be looking at using the ESP32 as a Bluetooth low energy client.
Or lease in the morning.
I've been messing around with Bluetooth low energy on the ESP32 for a while now, but I just couldn't get it to work as a Bluetooth client. Up until last week, when I discovered that Andreas Piece was doing the same work and he made a video about it and put it on YouTube. After taking a look at the code that he put on his GitHub, it all started to make sense. And it didn't take me long to get my BLE heart rate monitor to display my heart rate on the ESP32's OLED. And since I also own a BLE Flower Care smart monitor, I also started working on getting the data from that monitor. So let's start having some fun and use my heart rate to not only display it on the OLED display, but also dump it to an MQTT topic and make a light bulb respond to my heart rate. So let's start by opening the Arduino IDE, and I don't feel like wasting anybody's time, so I'll be going over this fairly quickly. If you have installed the ESP32 as a valid board in the Arduino IDE, if you don't, you can follow this link to a video where I'll explain how to do this. But if you have, then you'll find that there is an example installed under the ESP32 BLE Arduino. It's called BLE Client, and to start off we'll first see if it will compile. Also make sure that you have selected ESP32 as a board and you have selected the correct serial port. And on my system everything is A-OK. And we are ready to upload it to the board. We'll open up the Arduino IDE serial monitor. And it doesn't look right. And it's because we have the wrong baud rate selected, so let's change it. And now it's starting to look a lot better. On boot up, the BLE client sketch will start looking for Bluetooth low energy devices. And since I'm already wearing the heart rate monitor, we can see that it is found. Now, to be able to connect to it, we will need to connect to the service UUID, which stands for Universally Unique Identifier. So we will just copy it and paste it into the Arduino IDE. And once we are connected to the service UUID, we will want to read or write values and data. And with Bluetooth LE, this is done by using the characteristics UUIDs. In order to find these characteristics UUIDs, I went to the Bluetooth.com website. I did a search for heart rate measurement, and it told me that I needed to be looking for hexadecimal 2A for alpha 37. And a big shout out to Andreas Piece, because looking at his example I found out that we could be using the short notation in the following format. Let's compile and upload again and see what happens. This time we can see that we are actually connecting to the heart rate monitor. But what is this setting new characteristic value? Let's copy and do a search in the actual code. Aha, so the Bluetooth LE client example is actually sending data to a sensor. But we don't need it. It doesn't work for us, so we will just delete this bit of code. The other thing I noticed is that actually we're not receiving any data from the heart rate monitor. So I started searching for an answer on the internet, and I actually learned a lot about Bluetooth LE heart rate monitors. Turns out that they use a function called notify. In short, the sensor will not send out data until you actually enable the notify function. And we can enable it by sending a value of 0100 to the heart rate monitor. Funny thing is that I already found this information in September, but I couldn't figure out how to send it to the heart rate monitor. So I just put the project on hold. And again, thanks to Andreas Piece, I found out that it's actually quite simple. All we need is this little piece of code. Now, please bear with me when I am trying to modify the sketch, compile and upload. few errors here and there. But now, as you can see, we are actually receiving data from the heart rate monitor. 2 bytes. Now let's try to figure out to actually do something with these 2 bytes. Again, going back to the Bluetooth.com website, we can see that the heart rate measurement is actually a link that opens up, explaining us in detail how to read the actual data. The first byte is actually used to describe the data format for the complete packet. Looking at my heart rate monitor, it sends out the heart rate in an 8-bit format, so I'll be looking at the second byte for my actual heart rate. We'll add a small bit of code, compile and upload, and let's see what happens. And it's working. I can see my heart rate on the serial monitor. And yes, I can hear you thinking, but Timo, you were supposed to display it on the OLED display. And you are absolutely right. If you go to my GitHub, you can download a sketch that has the OLED, MQTT, everything built in. The only thing you do need to change is your SSID, your Wi-Fi password and your MQTT server. I have some lamps that are MQTT enabled and one of them is subscribed to the heart rate monitor's topic in MQTT. Now if my heart rate will go over a certain value, the light will switch on and it will switch off when my heart rate decreases again. This video is getting a bit long, so I will be saving the BLE MiFlora flower sensor for a later video. In the meantime, have fun with your internet connected heart rate, and I'm thinking this could be a thing. Maybe build this thing into a helmet with a flashlight on top. Would be a funny game, looking to see who can stay the coolest. Take it to a strip club, lap dance anyone? Leave your ideas in the comments down below. And as always, if you like this video, like, comment or subscribe, and stay curious.